You have built your website or any projects, and now you want to make it online so that you can share with your team members, friends, and so on. In this video, I'll show you how can you host your website for free. So I'm gonna use four different platforms: Google Drive, GitHub, Netlify, and w3schools. Therefore, in single video, you'll learn to host your website in Google Drive, GitHub, Netlify, w3schools, and it's completely free. Without further ado, let's start. Hello and namaste everyone. This is Jitsaru with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. In order to host our website, we are using four different platforms, and in order to use their services, first of all you need to register, so they will be providing different options for you. In all these four platforms, you can sign in with Gmail account. Therefore, let's create brand new Gmail account. You can go to accounts.google.com and you can create Google account. Just you need to fill the form. It's not that complicated. I hope you can do that. As you can see, this is my brand new Gmail account. Now if you click that apps icon, you will be able to get different products of Google. As you know, we are going to host our website in Google Drive. So let's click this Google Drive, and now you will be redirected to this page. Just skip this process, okay? You can see in single folder, I have stored all the necessary files. So let's open this index.html file in our browser. You can see this is the website that we are going to host, and I have given different features, something like scrollable, progress bar. Similarly, based on scrolling behavior, we'll show and hide our navigation bar, and along with that smart navigation bar, I have given their commission countdown timer. And not only that, if user is not providing any profile picture, in that case, based on their username, we are generating unique user's profile picture. If you want to build all this project, I have already created a separate video on this project. So playlist link will be given in the description below. You can check out. Just wait, there is another extra feature. If you select any specific text, you will be able to share that selected text in different social media. And also you can search with different search engine. Okay, now just pay attention. This is the important one. For your HTML file, it is mandatory to give HTML file's name as index.html. So just be careful. If you have different name, then just rename that file's name to index.html. Now you can drag this folder and drop it in my drive. Now after a few seconds, all the files will be uploaded. And now if you go inside that folder, you can see all the image containing folder, our HTML, CSS and JavaScript, all the files are successfully uploaded. Now you can just come to the root folder. If I right click, you can see option share. So if I hit that option, you can see there for general access, it's restricted. So let's change that access to anyone with the link. Now let's press that button done. And now let's go to this website, drv.tw. Now you will be redirected to this drive to web page, and you can get one of the option host on Google Drive. So let's choose that option. And now you need to choose your Google account. I'm choosing that brand new Google account that we have created just a moment ago. Now it's asking me to verify. So let's verify our account. And did you see that? It's asking your permission to access your Google account. So this is the reason why I did create brand new Google account. And now let's choose that option, allow. As soon as when you give your permission, you'll be redirected to this admin panel. Now it's ready. So in this way, you have hosted your website in Google Drive for free. As you can see, we can get there our website's link. But if you want to give custom domain, you can see just bottom there, you'll be able to change your site name. So I'm giving there Coding Design Development, and let's hit that option called set site name. And after a few seconds, it will generate new link for our website. Did you see that? Now if you click that link, congratulations, you have hosted your website, and that was completely free. And you can see everything is working completely fine. In this way, your website is now online. You can just copy that link and you can share with your friends, any team members. Now let's talk about another platform. I'm talking about GitHub. So if you visit this website, github.com, first of all, you need to sign up. Most of the sign up process, they are almost similar. So I'm just giving some basic information. Again, you need to give your Gmail account. So it's not really that complicated process. So I don't want to go really deep. Okay, so I'm just speeding up the process. In your Gmail account, GitHub will send you PIN code, and you need to verify your ID. And now you're ready to go. And also they do provide two different versions. So we are choosing the free version. And now finally we have created our account. So now you'll get this interface. If this is your first time, you might be overwhelming. It's not that complicated, don't worry. Now we need to create a repository. So for that, there are multiple options. On your screen, you can see if you press that plus icon, you'll get different options. You can choose new repository, and in your left side, you can see that green button. And again, you can find there create repository. So you can choose any one of these buttons. It's just that you need to create your new repository. Now you need to give name for your repository. So I'm giving coding design. If it's not available, it will automatically give you the information about whether that name is available or not. Okay. And also you can give description if you want, but it's not that necessary. So I'm leaving all the options as default. Now you can click that green button, create repository. And now if you have already created your repository in your local machine, then the process will be different. But this is our brand new repository that we have created in GitHub. So now you can create new files, or you can just upload an existing file. As you know, we have already prepared all the required files for our website. So just choose that option called upload an existing files. And now let's select all these files and folders. You can just drag and drop it. It is as simple as that. After a few seconds, you can see your all the files and folder, they are successfully uploaded, but that's not enough. Now we need to click that button, commit changes. Now we have successfully uploaded all the files and folders. Now we can go to the settings, and in your setting, you can see if you want to rename your repository, then you can just change that name. Okay. And now let's go to that pages. Now you'll be redirected to this GitHub pages. As you can see, our GitHub page that is currently disabled. So now let's select our branch to main and let's save it. And also you can give your custom domain. If you have already bought your domain name, then you can give that custom domain name. But in order to get link for our website, you just need to wait. After a few seconds, you can just refresh your browser. Now did you see that? You'll be able to get that link and you can visit your site. Congratulations, you have successfully hosted your website on GitHub for free. So as you can see, everything is working perfectly fine. And again, now you can just copy this link and you can share with anyone that you want to share with. Now let's talk about another platform, Netlify, which is pretty popular. Now you can go to this website, netlify.com. And again, you need to create your account. So now you can just sign up with your Gmail account. The reason for creating brand new Gmail account. So that was all for this. Every platform, they do provide these options. So it's pretty convenient. I'm filling up this form, and again you need to verify your account. So just verify your account and you're ready to go. Okay, it's asking some general questions, so I'm just giving random answers. And also it's asking me team name, so I'm just giving alpha. Now let's hit that button, continue to deploy. And now as we have already deployed our project in GitHub, then we can use that same files and folders by choosing this deploy with GitHub option. It's totally different topic. You can get started with another way. Okay, you can see there are two options. You can choose any templates, or you can try with Netlify drop. Now you can see you can just drag and drop your files and you are ready to go. So once again, I'm just dragging that folder and dropping it. Now did you see that we have created a brand new site? If you click that, but by default Netlify has given unique name for our site, so we need to change that. Okay, so now you can click that domain settings button. You'll be able to change your site name. So I'm giving their coding design. And now did you see that you will get that custom domain name. And if I click that link once again, congratulations, you have hosted your website on Netlify just for free. Now you can see your website is online. Once again, you can copy that link and you can share with different people. But you can customize lots of things. So if you have extra time, you can just explore all the options. Okay. Now let's talk about the last platform, which is w3schools. So now if you visit this website, w3schools.com/spaces. Now you can see this page. Again, you need to create your account. And once again, you can sign up with Google account. Now if you hit that spaces menu, you will be redirected to this page. And let's hit that option, get started for free. And you can see there are two options. Basic is free, but for full stack you need to pay certain amount of money. So we are using free version. And also you can see there are different templates you can use. But again, all the files and folders, they are ready for our website. So you can just choose that option blank. And now let's give the name for our space. And once again, I'm giving coding design. So based on that name, they will give you your custom domain name along with their subdomain name. Okay, so now you can just hit that create button. And after a few seconds, now you're ready to go. But as you can see, although that was blank page, if you hit that link, now you can see it's just basic site, nothing much more is there to see. Okay, so now you can just delete all these HTML and CSS file. Now as you can see, our root folder that is totally empty. And once again, you can just drag and drop that folder. After a few seconds, you will be able to upload all the files and folders. But the problem is that, as you can see, these two images were within our folder name images. So I can just copy that folder name and let's create new folder. I'm pasting the same folder name there. Let's hit that create folder button. And now we have created our folder. Now we need to move that two images within that images folder. So for that, you can choose that option, move to folder. And now you can move within that images folder. This is all the files and folder structure that we want. And now finally, once again, you can click that link. Congratulations, you have hosted your website on w3schools for free. And as you can see, everything is working completely fine. And once again, you can copy this link and share with your friends, team members, your boss. But as you know, it was a static website. If you want to host your dynamic website, then let me know in the comment box. If I get more requests, then I'll create a separate video on that topic. So that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it. And also, if you haven't already yet, hit that subscribe button and also the notification bell icon. Remember, there is always more to learn, so keep learning.